following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to Marty in Worcester. Hey, Marty, what's going on?
Hi, Mr. O'Brien. How are you?
I'm doing great. How you been, man?
Not bad.
Good.
In fact, you know, you guys, over the time and with a few of your courses and seminars, you know, you taught me how to fish.
That's a beautiful thing, brother. That's so cool.
Right, yeah, it's true. And so what happens is I still listen all the time, and to not only you, but some of the others.
Sure.
To, you know, get an idea where the fish might be biting.
Yeah.
But as far as your services, they're a bargain. When you compare them to a certain prominent man with real estate courses at $35,000 and no contact with the lecturers afterwards at all, and you think of what you guys do for a few hundred, and you can get access and ask questions forever, you know, it's a great deal.
No, we appreciate the growling problem with us out here.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Create the perfect relationship between you and your body. Treat your body with all love, honor, gratitude, and respect. When you make it a goal to adore your body and accept yourself completely, you are learning to have the perfect relationship with anyone else you are with. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 51, NASDAQ down 24, S&P's up 2, gold contract up $17.20, trading at $12.50 an ounce. Silver up 21 cents, $18.23 an ounce. Both gold and silver, folks, topside once again with volume. Now, in the gold contract, it's pretty cool. We have two separate ABC structures, one inside the other. One has a price projection. That's the one that's taken out the swing point today of a 1281. A larger one is 1289. Bottom line, we're at 1250. Looks to me like 1315 is going to be the number. 1315 is your swing point up in November 4th. Silver's up 21 cents, $18.23. Now, silver's been eaten through the supply line from November 11th. The top of that supply line is $19.10, and that's where I figure we're going to be running up to. Platinum's up $6.50 at $10.10 an ounce. You got copper. Copper's taking a beating out here. Copper's down 9 cents, $2.64 a pound. Light sweet crude up 84 cents, $54.43 a barrel. Notes. 10-year note up 10 ticks, 125.02. 30-year bond up 16 ticks, 151.28. Bottom line, notes and bonds continue higher. They have price spread, they have volume, they have all of the above. They want higher price, lower yield. King dollar. King dollar down 184 ticks at 101.010. King dollar is a confirmed ABC structure on the way down. You get a price projection on that of 96.925. Euro's at 105 and the yen is trading at 112.69. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Wanna know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have? Got another high. That's what we have. So the SPY's up 26 cents. You're trading out at 236.59. We've hit 236.90 today. You know, bottom line, you get 53 million shares. We'll probably do, I don't know, 73 million, something like that. Dow Industrials, and of course, you go to higher price, you can just keep going higher until you don't. Dow Industrials made another high up here today, up $49. You're at 20,824. Same type of setup, I mean, you know, you're stretched, no two ways about that. Volume out here today is going to be about 750, 800 million. The NASDAQ Composite, let's take a look at the composite. So the composite came down. We got as low as 58.09. It's already came back up like 20 points. It's only down 25 right now. And we'll see with the composite if we're going to have any type of juice at all. So intraday, you did have the volume on the way down. Looks like we're going to do about 1.85 billion. That's really not that much. The Qs have done 14 million. We're down 45 cents. They got as low as 129.45, right now you're at 130.05. Let's just take a look at this. Okay, so that's a normal retracement intraday for down, you know, for down market, well, down market, you know, down NASDAQ. This has a shot. Now this will be intriguing. This has a shot to, you know, get slightly lower. And what's going to be interesting coming into the close here, each and every close we've been coming into, they've been buying into the close. So we'll see how that shakes out today. Gold contract, bottom line, gold wants higher price. Wide price spread, has the volume, has all of it. We've done 246,000 contracts out here. You're taking the swing point out, that 225,000. You know, we're at 1250.60. You cleared the 1246.60. What's going to be intriguing here, no doubt, folks, is we're coming into a Friday. Fridays can be very challenging inside the metals market. That being said, what does happen is that when the trend's with us, which it is right now, it can also be very explosive. So bottom line, I expect it's going to continue higher. I expect, you know, at 1250 right now, you get 1281. That's pretty easy to get to on a Friday. It's only 30 bucks. But it's not the end of the world. Silver, same setup in silver. What you have with silver, there we go. Silver is trading at a price point of $18.16. And what we've done out here, you're eating right into the supply line from that November 11th downdraft. The bottom of that is $17.26. And you can see we've already eaten into that by 90 cents. That's saying that bottom line is that we're going to run up to this $18.95 to $19.10. Notes and bonds. We go take a look at notes and bonds. They continue to want higher price. Pretty amazing. Bottom line, it's clean, and it's clean in a big way. You talk about an expansion of volume. This is just amazing, folks. Okay, so check it out. The 10-year out here today has done 3.1 million contracts already. I mean, you're talking about buyers. Yesterday, we did 2.6 million contracts. Your swing point has 1.7 million. Now, you know, a 1.7 million day is a big day. You know, who's ever coming in this bond market is a monster. And bottom line, they're convinced that rates are going to go down versus up. We take a look at the 30-year, same type of setup inside the 30-year. 30-year, we've done 405,000 contracts, and that is way over what you normally do. Yesterday, we came in with 509,000. Pretty amazing, okay? Bottom line, this is also going after its higher swing, 153. I suspect we're going to get 155 out of this baby. And if we go over to King Dollar continually just can't handle the price. 32,000 contracts on the way down. Bottom line, we'll see how it goes after this 99,195 once again, which is its lowest swing. You stay right there, folks. We'll come right back. Dow Industrials right now are up 46. NASDAQ's down 25. S&Ps are up 2. We're going to be right back.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a 2-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your 2-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit tfnn.com.
In quiet markets, investors search for new trading opportunities. We'd like to introduce you to a new product that provides opportunities even in flat markets. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a new and innovative Chicago-based exchange registered with the Commodity Futures Trading Commission. And unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their trading platform. Nadex never charges a fee to use their platform, which even includes real-time charts and full customization capability. Nadex's unique short-term binary options allow traders and investors to capitalize on strategies even when the underlying markets are quiet. Nadex's innovation has allowed them to come up with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com, or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. Until recently, it was almost impossible for the average investor to hedge against currency risk in Europe or Japan. For a bold trade on Europe or Japan that protects against moves in currency, trade HEGE or HEGJ, 2x currency hedged leveraged ETFs from Direction Investments. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Tom, take your phone calls. Now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Welcome back, folks. Dow right now is up 45. You get the NASDAQ down 25. S&Ps are up 2. Let's go to Dave in Boston. Hey, Dave, what's going on? Oh, he's gone. So let's go to our man, Mr. Andy Hecht, as we do every Tuesday. And Dave. Sorry. Okay, let's go to our man, Mr. Andy Heckley's, as we do every Tuesday and Thursday. And don't forget, folks, Andy's got an outstanding show right here, 5 to 6 Eastern Standard Time, every Tuesday and Thursday. You can get that right on your cell phone. You go to TFNN.com. You hit Tiger TV. Now, as you're coming over to TFNN, folks, Andy's also got a great newsletter, the Technomento Commodity Report. The way you can test drive that is go to TFNN. You go to newsletters, you go to trading newsletters, you're going to see the Technomento Commodity Report, test drive at 30 days, absolutely free. Andy Hecht, what's going on?
Hey, Dave might not be there, but I'm here.
That's a beautiful thing. That's right, man. That's right. I like it. I like it.
How are you?
I'm doing great, man. Yourself?
I'm doing all right. I told you and I told everyone, all the listeners, I'm in the process of moving.
Yes.
And I tell you, moving is terrible. There's no other way. I mean, I'm very excited to move. It's going to be great. But, you know, we built this new house.
Right.
And, you know, it's always so difficult. So it got moved off a little bit. So I'll be back with you Tuesday.
Okay.
But, you know, then I hopefully, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday next week, I'll be doing that.
They're scrambling to finish the house. No, I got it. Believe me.
They're scrambling.
Oh, you listen, man, coming in for a close, and I do a lot of them, folks, it's intense. You know, someone's there, like, 6 days in a row, because all those details, those little details, got to be taken care of. You get a big house, man. There's a lot of details, you know.
That's right. We bought one of these next generation houses that my mother-in-law will live in, the kind of place next door.
Sweet.
So
yeah.
It's big.
Yeah.
It's a big place.
Huge.
And
yeah.
And yesterday there were 14 people working in the house.
Yeah. No. that's intense. Wow.
That's intense. It's like, I'm just staying away from there. Next Monday, I'll do the walkthrough and we'll figure it out. It should be great. It's going to be beautiful.
It is.
I just can't wait until I'm in there and it's over.
I know, man. No doubt.
And I have my new studio and I could talk to you from there. That's cool. What I'm looking forward to. So meanwhile, gold, man, gold looks good.
Yep. No doubt.
I heard you say last segment, you know, we're coming into crazy Friday. And in down markets, hey, Fridays are scary.
Right.
But in these kind of markets, you know, it's
the trend has been up, so the trend can really blow up.
Yes,
no doubt.
And silver is the one to watch tomorrow, folks.
Yeah.
Because silver is, you know, I've just been writing some articles here today, this morning, and getting ready for the show and doing my typical analysis. And I'm looking at silver, and silver, you know, if it closes above 1798 tomorrow, it's the ninth straight week of higher prices. And historical volatility in silver at 10% is a joke. Run out and buy call options because they're so cheap here because of volatility. And the bottom line is that if one is going to blow, it's going to be silver.
And it's just because it's been a slow move. That's interesting. Yeah, right. So watch, folks. Volatility is based on the moves. And, you know, silver has not stopped from $15.73, but it's been a slow climb. It has
crawling. Yeah. It's been crawling,
right,
lumbering. And, but hey, 9 weeks straight of gains. That's not, you know, that's not the norm, you know?
Yep.
Wow. That's not the norm. So let's talk about that. Those are the bulls. Let's talk about the bear today.
Okay.
And that is the copper market.
Oh, yeah, man. Copper's
look, copper got clocked today.
Yeah.
But I'm not that concerned here. I just think that there's going to be a lot of volatility in copper. Look, copper came down. It didn't come down on extraordinary volume. Copper is still in the trading range here. It's got to stay above 260, 260. You know, copper is a volatile metal. It always is. And you got to strike at Escondida. There's no end in sight to that strike right now. That strike can go on for at least, you know, a month, two more months. And BHP has already lost 41,000 tons of production. You have LME stocks falling. You have problems in Indonesia with the Freeport-McMoRan mine, which I think will get worked out. I think that they'll do some deal with the Indonesian government. I think the Indonesian government's probably looking for a piece of the action there.
Well, they already took it. That's what happened. They took
They took a piece.
And they signed the contract, and then it was like a forcible sign to do it, and then Freeport-McMoRan decided that, no, I'm not doing it. Okay, so they're trying to go back to the original contract. That's what's going on.
You know what? They'll negotiate it, and the bottom line is they'll do what always happens in a negotiation. Both sides will walk away unhappy, but both sides will make money.
There's no doubt. Yeah.
Right.
Just,
so that'll happen.
Just a matter of when. Right.
So that slows production down. Then you got problems in Las Bambas, which is the Peruvian copper mine. And you have a situation where demand is okay. It's buoyant. Listen, the Baltic Dry Index has gone from 688 to 806 over the last couple of sessions. So that's kind of a signal that things are good, you know, in terms of shipments of raw materials. Not necessarily copper doesn't go on those ships. But, you know, copper, iron ore, you know, lumber, all these things are kind of industrial.
Yes.
Bottom line, I think this is a buying opportunity. I think you scale down buy here. You know, you maybe start out a little bit here and you leave some room to buy. But I don't think copper's toast here.
Yeah, well, you know, I mean, to me, it's been a great run. I mean, a pullback is a pullback, meaning that
pullback is a pullback, and we get them all the time in these commodity markets. And you know what, Tom? In commodities, they're uglier than in other markets. They always are.
They are, man. I know.
So we'll switch our gears. I got a lot to cover with you today. Take a quick look at oil.
Okay.
The bottom line is, look at the chart. It's been in a $4.53 range since December 19th.
Yeah.
Now that was the range of days that we had, you know, back in a couple of months ago. That was a daily range.
Sure.
So nothing going on there. You know, we're at the top end of the range. Why? Because inventories came in, you know, way below expectations. In other words, the builds this week, I mean, we had some draws, and let me see if I have the numbers. Yeah, the API said almost a million barrels lower this week, and the EIA said 600,000 higher, but the market was looking for an increase of 3.5 million barrels. So, you know, that was kind of positive. And we had some draws in the gasoline and the distillates. EIA said today almost 5 million barrels down in distillates, 2.6 million down in gasoline. Bottom line there, you know, kind of supportive. figures today, but really nothing going on there. Nothing going on. But if you want volatility in energy, all you got to do is look at natural gas.
Yeah.
Because that thing is crazy. And here's something I want to point out to the listeners. You know, it's very easy to get very bearish on natural gas here, especially after it's fallen, especially after it's like $1.10 above where the lows were last year. But be very cautious, because open interest at 1.28 plus million contracts is the highest since 2013. And there are a lot of shorts in this market.
I see.
And it left a gap on the chart from last Friday to this Monday. And we could get some real crazy action here. I'm not that bearish on natural gas here because of the technicals.
Yeah, you stay right there. Andy and I are coming right back, folks. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Dow right now is up 48. NASDAQ is down 22. S&P's are up 2.5. We're going to be right back, folks.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
Today, it's hard to tell if the economy is coming or going. Regardless, I want my money going in the direction I choose. If that's your stance as well, then you want to know how EverBank can help keep your money thriving just the way you want. Is growing your money a priority? EverBank is committed to a yield pledge promise to pay high yields on your checking, money market, and CD balances. Looking to diversify? EverBank ingeniously developed accessible ways to spread your money around the world into foreign currencies and even non-FDIC-insured metals. And when it comes to your wealth, they bring a highly experienced and global perspective to help you manage it. EverBank's financial philosophy flies in the face of the status quo. They believe your money's performance should not be determined by today's economic circumstances, but by the drive to rise above them and create opportunities that favor your objectives. If that excites you, like it does me, call 1-855-750-4051 to find out what they can do for you. That's 1-855-750-4051. Call them today. EverBank is a member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. We're talking with our man, Mr. Andy Heck. We are talking commodities. Right now, we have the Dow up 38, NASDAQ's down 26, S&Ps are up a buck and a half. And, you know, the corn, soybeans, where are we going with those babies?
Yeah, so I was going to actually bring those up after the WASDE last on February 9th. You know, okay. We had some nice little rallies.
Okay.
And now we're coming back down. And this is all, you know, the markets rallied on the fact that the USDA is telling the markets, hey, there is consistent demand for these grains. And that's not going anywhere fast. And they said, you know, the markets scratched their head. They say, hey, you know, 2017 crop year, nothing is for sure here. So they took them a little bit higher. Now they're coming off as they realize that, you know, there are still big inventories from four straight years of bumper crops. But, you know, the way I look at these markets, especially this time of the year where there is so many uncertainties going into the new crop year, I'm a scale down buyer of soybeans, of corn, of wheat here, you know, on these sell-offs. And I like to keep a small core long, but I will take profits on rallies like we saw, you know, after the WASDE. I think you're going to see a lot more of that. You know, grains become much calmer when we know we have empirical evidence, you know, well, during the growing season, during the harvest season. But now it's all conjecture. And so you're going to see a lot of volatility in these markets. And you're seeing it pick up here, you know, with up moves, with down moves, and so on and so forth.
What do you think about the, you know, I was reading an article today that, like, when you're looking at the beans, corn, and bulk, so much of that gets sold to China, right?
Yeah.
That, you know, we get in a trade war. Are the farmers, you know, is that on the table, you think?
Well, I mean, you know, it's always possible, but quite frankly, China has to eat. And we're the largest world producer of corn and soybeans.
Right.
Puts us in a pretty good negotiating position. I don't think we're getting into any trade wars. I think it'll be negotiated out eventually. I think there'll be scares, certainly. But I really think that, hey, 1.4 billion people need to eat. The United States produces 30% of the world's soybeans. I think a little bit more when it comes to corn. Wheat is more ubiquitous around the world, but
most of the beans and the corn that we're sending over there, they use it for feed, right? Do they use it to feed people or feed animals?
Well, both, really. Okay. You know, it depends. The soybean oil that we send over there is cooking oil.
Okay.
So, you know, that's
okay.
For people.
Sure.
The soybean meal we send over there is certainly for animals.
Okay.
And the corn, hey, corn has so many uses, Tom. It's amazing. I mean, everything from, you know, corn on the cob to ethanol to paper starches to all kinds of things. So, you know, these are very, there's a lot of utility with these, these grains.
Yeah.
So, the bottom line is, you know, global demand, it's going to continue to underpin support. You know, whatever happens between nations and trade, you know, those are temporary blips, in my opinion. I think at the end of the day, what you see is, hey, more people every day, and they got to eat. That means we need more to feed them.
You know, I hear you loud and clear, but I remember going back a long time ago when us and Russia were going at it. When we calmed down and those first wheat shipments were coming out of the U.S., wheat went to the moon. Do you know what I mean?
Right.
Like, at certain points we'd push, meaning, you know, we'd export wheat. Other times we wouldn't. But when those orders would come in, wheat would go to the moon a second, right?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely. And you know what else the interesting thing is? You know, when you look at wheat is like my favorite of these commodities. And it's been under siege the worst. But I love wheat because wheat is, you know, such a political commodity, because bread is like the ultimate staple.
Yeah,
you know,
for
I know
sure.
It's not good for you,
no,
but
for,
around
for
the world.
Sure. Right. But
it's
guess
the
what?
Ultimate staple.
You eat it and you feel good. I mean, it's crack.
That's right.
It's sugar, but I agree, man. It's
the ultimate. And you know what, Tom? I mean, if you look back in history, you know, today we say what commodity causes all the wars. Everyone will say oil. It's really wheat. It's wheat riots and the French Revolution. And it's all of those, you know, it's all of those kinds of things. So wheat, we planted the smallest winter wheat crop this year because of large inventories.
Okay.
Since 1909.
Wow.
I mean, that's a long time.
That's a long time.
Hey, that's older than you and me. So that's a long time.
Just barely. No.
but the point is that, you know, it's like the cyclicality of commodities. So you have this situation where you have a lot of inventories, you plant very little,
yes.
And then all of a sudden you have a shortage before you know it.
Yep.
No, that's,
so,
you can see that.
So I'm kind of really like it. And what I've been seeing lately, you know, I watched the Kansas City versus the Chicago wheat.
Okay.
And because of the big surpluses, you know, Kansas City wheat went to like a 20-cent discount to Chicago wheat. The norm is like a 20 to 30-cent premium, and it's been as high as a dollar premium for that hard red winter wheat that they trade on the Kansas City exchange. Well, that's gone from a 20-cent discount a couple of months ago back to about an 18-cent premium. And that's a positive sign for me for wheat. So I think, you know, if the stars line up right, we could see a lot of volatility in the wheat market in the months ahead, especially if the crop isn't good. If you get a drought, you know, so many countries produce wheat. You got a lot of wheat coming out of Russia,
yeah,
around the Black Sea region of Odessa.
Okay.
That's the port. You got a lot of wheat coming out of Australia, South America, the United States, Canada. All you need is a problem in one of those areas.
Right.
Because everything is the marginal bushel. So you get one problem. You get a drought in Australia, and, you know, the wheat could blow, you know, blow to the moon. So, you know, I think the downside's very limited. The upside is explosive, and that's why I like to trade these from long these days. But I do take some profits on rallies, keeping small core positions. I think that's the way to approach those grain markets as we
go into
this.
And, well, you know, it's really cool, too. I mean, you know, if the dollar continues to, you know, have that selling pressure, that in itself is going to help all these commodities.
Absolutely. Right. Yeah. And you know what? The administration, love them or hate them, they're telling markets loud and clear, we want the dollar lower.
Yeah, well.
And whether they can do it or not, you know, they want the dollar lower. There's no question about it. So the other thing I want to point out to our listeners here is gasoline.
Okay.
You know, gasoline has been depressed, and that's there's really a seasonal function to the gasoline market here. And I want to put up a weekly chart of the gasoline crack spread. Gasoline crack spread in March just went down to under $10.
Okay.
I'll still have it on my screen here. Let's just get it up there for you. And I mean, the moral to this story is really I want people to look at Valero stock, and if you could take a quick look at that, Tom.
Yeah.
Could see that the crack spread is up about 1881 here because we've switched from March to April. It's not that we had a massive rally, it's that we've gone from the low end of demand to the higher end of demand time of the year. And you see this happens each year.
Okay.
But I think what we're going to see is we're going to see, you know, this thing trade up between $20 and $25, and that's going to be very supportive of Valero. And I see Valero's up over $1 today.
Yeah.
And that's a very cheap stock on a PE basis. It pays a very nice dividend, over 4%. And I think that's a way to participate in the coming, you know,
yeah,
recovery in gasoline. And gasoline prices, listen, they can go back to $2 very easily here.
Pretty amazing, no doubt. Well, listen, we appreciate all the work. Look forward to the show at 5 o'clock. We're going to send you lots of good white light for a good move, man.
Thanks, buddy.
Okay, have a great one. Thanks, Andy. Thank you. You stay right there, folks. We're coming right back. Dow's up 35, Nasdaq's down 27, S&P's are up 1. We're going to be right back.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den, but wondered, what exactly is it? The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of your favorite TFNN shows, plus see all the charts as they happen live during those shows and have access to all those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days. It will greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com. Tiger TV is an exciting way to experience TFNN programming. See high-definition video giving you crystal-clear charts, as well as seeing some of the faces of TFNN's highly acclaimed financial experts with crisp, full-fidelity sound. Catch Tom O'Brien, John Logan, Steve Rhodes, Basil Chapman, Larry Pesavento, Think or Swim, David White, Andy Hecht, and Daryl Martin in crystal-clear, high-definition audio and video. Tiger TV, exclusively at TFNN.com.
Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund is currently offering 4-year first mortgages on many of the fully renovated properties that it has purchased. The first mortgages are third-party appraised with a maximum loan-to-value ratio of 70%, providing a secured investment that pays a fixed return of 5% annually, which works out to a monthly income of more than $416 per $100,000 investment with your principal intact and secured. These four-year first mortgages are perfect for anyone looking for a secured investment that provides monthly income much like a CD. For more information, email tigerfund@tfnn.com or click on the Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund banner along the right side of the tfnn.com homepage or call our office directly at 877-518-9190. There's a limited supply, so act now. The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now.
Tom, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. The Dow right now is up 38. You get the Nasdaq down 26. S&Ps are up a buck and a half. If we do go over and we take a look at the Fed Fund futures, what you're going to see is that the probability that we get a March rate hike, March 15th, is 38%. May 3rd is 62%. What did come across this tape, which was kind of interesting, is that the CME, they broke all records yesterday, folks, trading in the Fed Fund futures. So there is a monster battle out there between all traders as to when are these rates going to go higher. So pretty amazing. And that being said, you know, when we take a look at this 10-year and the 30-year, these volumes coming in are just amazing, folks. You know, when I started the program, you know, we were talking about it, but you're talking about 3.1 million contracts in the 10-year. That's, you know, and what this is doing, it's coming into the swing high and you're coming in with volume. So your probability is much higher that, number one, you're going to take out, or you're going to get into the swing high, but number two, to take out the swing high. When you're pushing into a swing high or swing low and you have an expansion of volume like this, you know, I've seen it quite a bit. I mean, your probability goes much higher that you're going to take it out. Yesterday, we did 2.6 million contracts. Today, 3.1. That's a big number coming in. If we go take a look at some of the higher volume stocks in this market, not that it's going to be a high volume market out here today, you'll see a few of them have got really toasted pretty good. Well, Square was up. That was that caught a nice bid in the way up, 15% up, actually. It's up $1.99. Cliffs Natural is down $1.15. U.S. Steel is down $2.93. L Brands, that's getting toasted. That thing's in big trouble. That's down $9.30. You have Transocean's up $1. We go to, let's see where Tesla. Tesla's not only down, you're at 256, you're down $16.56. There's some good volume behind this move. 13.9 million shares. And that is with a 29% shot position. It's, well, 27.98% shot position in Tesla. So, that's pretty intense just in itself. And if we do look at Tesla, the first place that there's actually some support is right where it's at. It's actually right there. Yeah, the top of it was 269. The bottom of the support is 240. With that number there, that is where that was the last swing high on April, the week of April 8th. So we'll see how it handles it. Now, the deeper that you get into that bar, the higher the probability goes that you can go right down to the beginning of this run, which was in February of 2016, which would be pretty intense because the beginning of this run started at 141. That would be a wake-up call in an incredible way. There's no two ways about that. We take a look at the IWM, the small caps. They had some movement out here today. You had an expansion of volume. Small caps are trading at 138.70. This close inside 138.82 gets you a probability that you can get a second day of red in the marketplace. And that'll just be incredible because we haven't seen that in a long period of time, folks. What you do have with these small caps is that you're back in the consolidation, and the IWM, you're at 138.70. The bottom of this consolidation is 133.17. So that would be quite a move if, in fact, that's where they end up closing out. The NDX 100, the three Qs, that has a long way to go before I can even tell you anything. You know, three Qs, this has been a one-way trade. 118, it was trading 118 December 30th. And you're at, you hit 130.70 today. So that's no doubt an incredible move. You know, let's go look at the IBB because the IBB, that was putting some selling pressure inside the NASDAQ composite. Now, with the IBB, this still needs more volume for the way down. You've done 860,000. It's not a lot of volume. You know, I mean, we've gone from 295 to 289. We hit 286 out here today. So what 289 does for you, it does not get you back in the lower range. You know, I want to see this IBB, two different things. I want to see the IBB get under 287.17, meaning that we are short the position and go lower. And an expansion of volume. We still haven't got the expansion of volume. You know, so we'll see where that whole thing is going to shake and bake. The financials, we take a look at the financials, the XLF. Inside the financials out here, they're just hanging at the high with no volume. The energy sector, this baby's in trouble. So this is subtle, but this is in big trouble. This is going to be cool watching this shake out, and this is what it is. So the XLE is down from $76.45. You're not only down there, though. You are hammering this last high-volume swing low, which is $70.65. The 16 million shares is at that low. We're going to do about 15.5 million today. That's a big heads up that it wants to break number one, and then it will go after how it came off the lows in September of 2016. 2016, we were laying down there at $66.71. You know, bottom line is, you get something like that, you're talking about the big oil stocks inside the XLE. That in itself will, you know, keep some real pressure on the indices. You know, we'll see if in fact someone else can take them over, meaning another sector can take them over. But with that type of selling, you can expect some pressure here. You know, as we come into the close here, we got 11 minutes coming into the close. It's going to be intriguing to see if in fact that Dow, the Dow's up $23 right now, if in fact it can just close flat. It'd be pretty wild if it does. There's no two ways about that. You know, what you do have out here, there's no doubt. There's some profit taking coming, you know, right across all these indices. Coming into a Friday, you get some profit taken. We'll see where it shakes out. Jack in the Box, that came out with numbers last night, too. Now, that sold off into the close and then just got hammered out here today, down 7.42. You know, 5 days ago, it was trading at $112. You're at $96 right now. You hit 93.04 intraday. The way this baby is set up right now is that you get the volume off the highs. And volume off the highs, folks, is always dangerous after you've had a nice acceleration topside. You know, if we go over to the GDX there, as the market is selling down, they're trying to sell this GDX. Well, they are selling the GDX down too. It's at 24.42. The top of that gap is 24.36. Interesting. Okay. Never said it was going to be easy. That's for sure. You stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. Dow Industrials right now up 27. Nasdaq's down 27. That's pretty cool. S&P's are flat. We're going to be right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date, active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a 2-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your 2-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by TFNN. Test drive all the newsletters for free at TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dow right now is up 20. You got the Nasdaq down 29. S&P's absolutely, they're down almost a full point, folks. Okay, miracles do happen out here. Let's go take a look at how the volumes are going to come in. On the NYSE, we are at right now, let's see, you're at 685. That's going to probably do 800. On the Nasdaq Composite, you're trading out at, the Composite's 1.6 at 6.5. That'll do about 1.85. That's how that's shaking out. If we go take a look at the trend, bottom line is that, now this is where this gets really interesting. The trend's at 1.67. Now, what a 1.67 says, folks, is that everyone is selling the same stocks. You don't get highs at a 1.67. This is pretty amazing, actually. And So when the market is even, meaning that the buying and selling is distributed, you get a trend of one. When you get a trend of a blown out number like this, they're doing the same thing, you know, whether it's a buy or a sell. In this particular case, you know, a 1.6, I suspect what that is all about is that the amount of folks that are basically selling the same stock, that's where that's coming in, okay? So bottom line, that's not saying that you got a top in at all. If we take a look at the tick reading, you've had a plus 1,067 and minus 659, and that's not saying anything either. What you want to watch for here in a big way is that you've got a couple of the bigger stocks destroyed out here today, pretty good. You came off the highs, you came off with volume. You get a few more of the high flyers doing that, then you'll see some down action. You know, Tesla is probably the first one that got some big action like that. You can't, Victoria's Secrets, you know, that's already been a dog. You know, that's down $9. But when you take a look at this equity's gone from $100 to $48. What this equity is showing, though, in a big way, is that absolutely malls are in huge trouble. You know, that's where all these the Victoria's Secrets stores are in. And, you know, you're sitting in a mall. The mall owners are in trouble. The mall people are in trouble, you know, because the bottom line is that we're shopping other places outside of the mall. And that's the cut and dried how this thing is shaken out, which is pretty wild. Because if you do you still go over to SPG, which is the largest mall owner, you know, now this is down big, but it hasn't fallen apart yet. You know, Simon's, yeah, it's not even close to falling apart. The high is 228. You're at 184. You know, that's something you're going to keep an eye on, though. Now, that's the tier one. The tier two, if you look at Kimco Realty, now this is falling apart. This is like a tier two, one of the biggest tier two mall holders. That has gone from 32 to 24. You know, so that's definitely have more pressure. Those types of malls would be, they're not just strip malls. They're larger malls, but they're not like where the Macy's are and the Nordstrom's are, you know, bottom line. More so you get a nice theater, you get Publix, you'll get a Target, you'll get some hairdressing salons, you'll get some nice bars, you know, that's how that baby shakes out. So. As we come into this close, we'll see if the S&P can stay negative. Each and every day, they've juiced it coming right into the close. There's no doubt about that. And we're also going to have a lot of numbers coming out right after the close, folks. Dow Industrials right now, up 22, Nasdaq's down 30, S&P's are down 0.5%. You stay right there, folks. We'll be back with some numbers for you.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated folic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
This is TFNN.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to our man Dave in Clearwater. Hey, Dave, Happy New Year. What's happening, man?
Happy New Year to you, my brother. How are you, sir?
I'm doing great, man. How you been?
I am doing well, man. I'm doing well. Can I throw a quote out at you?
Sure.
In the market, somebody knows something. Someone always knows something. That statement was made by a great trader by the name of Tom O'Brien about 6-7 years ago.
Oh, yeah.
And it kind of hit me like a brick. Well, you're right. Somebody always knows something.
Hey, Carlos, what's going on, brother?
I'm calling you back, Tom. This morning, I had a pleasure to talk to you and your son, and I don't want to miss the opportunity to talk to you again.
Well, I think you made some money on this bond.
Oh, yes, Tom. Your newsletter helped me.
That's a beautiful thing. We appreciate the growling problem that's out here.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Don't take anything personally. Ignore the opinions of others. Whatever people do, feel, think, or say, don't take it personally. Others are going to have their own opinions according to their belief system. So whatever they think about you is not about you, but is about them. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials up 34, NASDAQ down 25, S&P's up 1.5, gold contract up $16.60, trading at $12.49.90 an ounce. Silver up 20 cents at $18.23 an ounce. Both gold and silver, folks, wide price spread, have the volume behind the move. You got the gold contract taking out another B point of an ABC structure on the way up. You have two separate ABCs now on the way up. We got one with the price projection of 1281. You get a longer term one, 1289. Bottom line, I suspect we're going to get there. That being said, we're going to change this up a little. I'm going to go right over to the GDX. Why? If you take a look at the GDX, which are the gold stocks, folks, okay? Bottom line, GDX is trading 24.37. We did 44 million shares out here, and yeah, this is going to be a trip, watching this thing shake out, coming into a Friday. And specifically what I mean is this, is that you had the GDX sell off as we come into the close. We go take a look at Barrick Gold. Barrick Gold ABX, which is the largest weighting structure inside the GDX. That bottom line, that got to was 2026 at the high, 1969. You're still, it looks like it wants to fill up this gap at 1937. Now, Newmont, which is the second largest weighting structure inside here, also couldn't hold its high. You're coming into a high volume low from yesterday. We'll see how that shakes out tomorrow morning. Goldcorp is the third largest weighting structure inside here. Take a look at Goldcorp. Goldcorp also got to a high of 1728. We closed at 1682. You take a look at the XAU, what the XAU did, that got to 91.86. You closed at 89.61. You know, when you start wrapping all these together, what I expect you're going to see and do out here tomorrow is that I do expect that we're going to see gold continue higher, silver continue higher, and the metals themselves, the equities themselves, I do expect them to go higher, but I expect there's going to be a cat fight and a dog fight and a bear fight and a bull fight in the morning in a big way. That's how this seems to be shaking out. Notes. We go take a look at the note market. What do we have with notes? 10-year note out here. Monster volume, folks. Okay. So the note and the bonds, 10-year note, 30-year bonds, they had huge volume yesterday and today. We did 3.2 million contracts out here today. Yesterday, you know, you did 2.6. Most times, folks, big contract volume inside the 10-year is 1.7. So that's telling me, number one, we're going to get up to the high tomorrow, which is an additional 14 ticks. We very well might break it. Now, if that's the case, is going to be that should put selling pressure inside the S&P. I know that's a sacrilege and there's no such thing as that, but We'll see. We'll see how it shakes out. So 30-year, we go take a look at the 30-year bond. 30-year also had huge volume in it today. We take a look at the 30-year. 30-year did 439,000 contracts. Big contract volume for the 30-year, folks, is like 257,300. You're approaching the swing high, which is 153.21. So that's a point in 20 ticks. Expect we're going to get into it. King dollar. What do we have with king dollar? We take a look at king dollar. What we have with king dollar is this, folks. King dollar out here trading at a price point of 100.960. You've done 32,000 contracts. Those 32,000 contracts, you know, bottom line, you come into a little swing area here with 41,000. And I expect we're going to go after it. You know, king dollar's in a confirmed ABC structure on the way down. That has a price point, a price projection of 96.925. We go up and we take a look at the S&Ps. What do you have with the S&Ps? S&Ps out here went to another high, stayed at a high. That means you can get higher. We're at 236.44 in the S&Ps. We take a look at the Dow Industrials. Also made another high, at another high, all of the above. We're 20,810. It's almost like we were just at 20,000. We've done 1,000 points in, let's see, 20 days. Not 20 trading days, 20 calendar days. We were at 19,800 on the 2nd of February. NASDAQ Composite. So the composite and the small caps, they went down slightly. Composite was off $25. You did, you're at 58.35. Volume-wise, inside the composite, we did 1.86 billion. We take a look at the 3Qs. That also pulled back slightly. That was down 49 cents, 17 million. Small caps also pulled back, and had an expansion of volume. Now, the small caps, once again, are showing that they are the weakest indice. The small caps are the only indice, folks, that are also still in the consolidation. They were outside the consolidation that we've been in since December 5th. They got back outside that consolidation 7 trading days ago, and they came back inside. And they came back inside with an expansion of volume. You'll see how this shakes out. We had hit a high with 21 million shares on Tuesday. We come back inside it today with 24 million shares. Now, what that does set up is that it has a shot to get to the bottom of this consolidation. And that would be quite a move in the context of how markets have only moved up. We are at 138.75. 133.17 would be the lower end of this consolidation that we're trading in right now. We're going to take a look at the silver market. What do you have with silver? Silver also has the juice behind it, has the volume behind it. We've done 96,000 contracts. You're at a price point out here of $18.17. And as I said a little bit earlier, that's also in an ABC structure on the way up. And this is another ABC that silver's doing, actually. 1663. It's a good one, too. It's a big one. Silver's going up to this $19.12. Gold's going to the 1289. You stay right there, folks. We'll come right back.
If you're an active trader looking for that extra edge when it comes to trading and investments, then now is a great time to get a 2-week free trial to Tom O'Brien's daily market letter, Market Insights. Tom O'Brien's daily newsletter, Market Insights, comes out every market day at around 9:30 a.m. and provides Tom's daily commentary on the broad market, including the Dow, NASDAQ, and S&P, plus specific trade recommendations. There's even an update published most afternoons to keep you informed about the day's market activity. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock and option trade. With Market Insights, there's nothing left to guessing. For all the details and to get your 2-week free trial to Market Insights started today, visit tfnn.com.
Has the current market volatility continued to stop you out of trades when the market spikes against you? Now is the perfect time to open up an account with Nadex. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a brand new, completely regulated Chicago-based exchange, and unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their completely free trading platform, which also features real-time charts and full customization capability. One of the advantages of trading with Nadex in volatile markets is that your risk is always capped and you have the ability of keeping your trades open even when the market spikes against you. Nadex is completely brand new with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at nadex.com. That's nadex.com. Or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of tfnn.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Tom, take your phone calls.
Now.
Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Welcome back, folks. Some of the high-volume stocks in this continually low-volume market. This is what you had moving out here today. Chesapeake Energy was off 17 cents. NVIDIA, we're going to go back to that one. That's a big hit. NVIDIA was down $10 or 10%, trading at $100, and that was a high flyer. U.S. Steel got hit. That's down $3. General Electric's down 7 cents. You got L Brands. That's Victoria's Secrets. That got hit. That's down $9 at $48. Dollars. Transocean was up $1. And let's go to NVIDIA first and take a look at NVIDIA. So this was a one-way ride on NVIDIA until it wasn't. So this come down, broke. So the high in NVIDIA is 120. Oh, this is always dangerous. Check this out. So NVIDIA, folks, has volume off the highs, too. This is going to be interesting to see how this shakes out. So NVIDIA made a high of $119.93 on December 28th. You had 57 million shares traded. $119.93. Okay. You come down to 99. You go all the way back up to... Yeah, you tested it. Unbelievable. You hit 120.93 with 18 million shares. So you can see there's your test. You have an expansion topside, big volume. You have a test and you fail again. Then what you have here is that you had 2 days coming off that high in December with volume. Now we get another one. We're breaking the swing points with volume. That's saying the next stop on NVIDIA is down at $88.77. Let me just see this. That's going to be a big problem, see, because what happened is this. As soon as you're under $102 in NVIDIA, it's wide open to 88. And because this stock was a one-way move, one-way moves are great on the way up, folks. Bottom line, they're a disaster on the way down because they don't have any floors. Yeah, so this is a big number. Tesla also got banged around. Tesla down $17.52. Huge volume, 14 million shares. This little baby also 243 is the next stop on this. You know, it's basically ate through the support that it had at 269. The top of that was the week of April 6th. 269 was the high. Bottom line, the low of that is 240. That's where it wants to go. So there's going to be some big action out here. SPLK, let's see what this is. Okay, so this is a web-based application company. This closed at $64.90. That's trading at $59.63. And let's see what they have to say. Okay, so the revenue estimate was $288 million. They took in $306. Bottom line estimate was 17 cents. They took in 25 cents. You got to love it. You guess what? That's not enough. that's what that's coming down to. The market wanted more out of it. That's how that shakes out. OLED, which is, let's see, flat panel display infrastructure. That closed at Universal Display. That closed at $67.45. That's trading right now at $76. What a pump up that is, man. Holy cow. That's, I guess we're using those displays. Let's see what it says. Okay, so the estimate was $68 million. They took in $74. Bottom line estimate was $43 million. They took in $55. Let's go to Rick and Natick. Hey, Rick, what's going on?
Hey, Tom, how are you? Thank you.
Sure. I'm doing good. Yourself?
Good. Not bad. Not bad.
Good.
I talked to you about AKS about a couple months ago.
Yeah.
Remember. I just got that one. You know, it seems like it's hammering at $8, and I tried to go below $8 and still hanging on. So I just got it. I just bought it. I don't know if I make a mistake or not, but you tell me what could happen. Although I own the AMD, but, you know, and it seems like it's been A, B, C, D, you know, up. What do you think about that one?
Okay, so let's take I'll do an AMD Advanced Micro first, right? So.
Yeah.
Advanced Micro, let's see. So, took out a B point. The question is, where is he? Let me put this on a weekly. It's probably a weekly ABC up, too. Yeah, it is. So, that's easier to gauge. Okay, so 622 is a 1242. So, $6.20 gets you 1560.
15 what?
$15.60.
60 cents.
Yeah.
So, that would be the C point.
I know, that would be the D point.
D point, yeah, ABC, okay.
Yeah.
Do you think you can, because I hear so many things from the analysts that could, you know, it could double to $25 if that product comes out on the market, which, you know, will compete with Intel then after that.
The way that NVIDIA traded out here today,
yeah,
I wouldn't be hanging around in AMD.
Okay.
You know, I mean, they took apart NVIDIA by 10%.
Right.
They're in the same business.
That. Yeah.
Yeah. Now, let me just see something else. Okay, so who else does that? So you got NVIDIA, SnapTax, let me just see. Okay, so SYNA. That come down. Yeah, that's already down. I wouldn't be hanging around there. You know, I don't know, you know, why the NVIDIA thing, they took it apart like that, but it's very unusual that you get a leader like that. They'll take it about 10%, and AMD, you know, held its own out here for sure. But you're only a point away from finishing the whole ABC structure on the way up.
Yeah. And you could, you know, once you finish the first, you know, ABC, it could start the second one, ABC, up?
That's what it can do, but most times what equities do, whether it's an ABC up or an ABC down, is that then they do just not the opposite. It's not like, but they do a correction, you know.
Before they start the new one.
That's correct.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. And AKS, I'd be careful with AKS. I think the steel company is going to get killed, man. You know, I mean, Trump had the steel companies in there today, and, you know, he can't save them, man. You know, he's in there saying, yeah, I'm going to save you. I'm going to do this and do that. Well, guess what? You know, the markets, you know.
I just wondered because it was hanging up, you know, at $8. It went down below $8 and then went up back up. I mean, it's hammering the $8. That's why it was, I thought maybe it would be a good entry point. Because when we talked about it, you said it could go as low as between, you know, $7 to $5.50. You know, I had it at $11.30, so I do have a lot of bread on it, but that's why.
Yeah, I'd move it out, man. This can be an ABC down. I wouldn't hang out.
Okay,
man. No, have a great one. Have a safe one. You stay right there, folks. We'll come right back.
Today, it's hard to tell if the economy is coming or going. Regardless, I want my money going in the direction I choose. If that's your stance as well, then you want to know how EverBank can help keep your money thriving just the way you want. Is growing your money a priority? EverBank is committed to a yield pledge promise to pay high yields on your checking, money market, and CD balances. Looking to diversify? EverBank ingeniously developed accessible ways to spread your money around the world into foreign currencies and even non-FDIC insured metals. And when it comes to your wealth, they bring a highly experienced and global perspective to help you manage it. EverBank's financial philosophy flies in the face of the status quo. They believe your money's performance should not be determined by today's economic circumstances, but by the drive to rise above them and create opportunities that favor your objectives. If that excites you, like it does me, call 1-855-750-4051 to find out what they can do for you. That's 1-855-750-4051. Call them today. EverBank is a member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
Tom O'Brien's weekly gold letter, The Gold Report, gives complete and concise coverage of the entire gold market. Inside, you'll get Tom's commentary on gold, the dollar, the rand, the bond, the XAU, the HUI, and detailed coverage of nearly 25 mining stocks. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price of each stock trade. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. With a lifetime of knowledge and almost 12 years of writing his informative weekly newsletter, The Gold Report, Tom O'Brien can provide you with the important market information to help you make better trades in the gold market. Don't let the next bull run in gold pass you by. To get a month-long free trial to The Gold Report, an $85 value, visit the front page of TFNN.com today.
TFNN has put together the finest live programming lineup each trading day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected financial minds in the nation to educate traders and investors. On Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays, we broadcast 9 hours a day starting at 8 a.m. as John Logan kicks us off each trading day with the Global Market Pulse. Tuesdays and Thursdays, we broadcast 11 hours. Get an early and healthy start to your day as Nico and Paige bring you Living a Primal Lifestyle. Then catch Andy Hecht at 5 p.m. with the Commodities Hour. Following the Tom O'Brien Show, Mondays and Fridays, catch live trading on the Nadex platform with host Tom and Tommy O'Brien, along with Gerald Martin on the Bull Bear Binary Option Hour. See the TFNN program lineup via the link on the front page of TFNN.com to get a complete overview of our TFNN shows and hosts, and keep TFNN's Tiger TV tuned in on your mobile device, PC, or Mac for the latest financial news and information throughout the broadcasting day. TFNN, educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Let's go take a look at this little baby is getting toasted out here. So you got Acadia Communications. They design, develop, manufacture communication equipment. This closed at $63. This is trading right now at 52. And, oh, look, this has been getting killed, too. Wow, okay. So this is a one-way trip. Holy cow. This is $128 in September of 2016. And this is a new issue. It's going right back to $42. Let's see what they have to say. So their revenue is $142 million. Estimate was 90 cents. They made 94. Bottom line, they're not growing quick enough. You know, they've made their numbers, but they must have either brought those numbers down because the market's not believing them. We go to Restoration Hardware. Restoration Hardware, I think. Yeah, Restoration Hardware, that closed at $25.19. That's trading at $28.75. Now, this is an equity that already got killed. This thing, the last earnings out, it just got destroyed. Not just the last one. So this used to be a $106 stock. And it's going to be another one that I think in this one here, what you have, folks, is that they have built not only large stores, they're extraordinarily large. I haven't made it to one in Tampa, Florida yet, but I got to make it there. Because this is just an overhead that's just a monster. Let's see what they're saying. So their estimate was $584 million. They made $586 million. They're going to do a $300 million share repurchase authorization. That's a buyback. Depends on how long they're going to take to do that. The estimate of the profit was 66 cents. They made 68. You know, I don't know if they've been buying the stock back before, but at least they're not buying the stock back when it was $100. It's $25 right now. A little bit better, no doubt about that. PCLR, and thanks, Dave, for putting all these in the den. Appreciate it, man. PCLR. I get that one wrong. Okay. Baidu, or BIDU. Let's go take a look at this. So we all know what Baidu does. Baidu closed at 184.64. That is trading at 187.59. And let's see what they're saying. Their revenue is $2.62 billion. They missed their revenue projection, but the market's still putting them up $5. The estimate was $2.64 billion. They made $2.62. Earnings per share. Can't find the earnings per share. Interesting. I'll hunt it, but I can't seem to find it. Let's go to Mike in Somerville. Hey, Mike, what's going on?
Hey, Tommy, how you doing, buddy?
I'm doing great, man. How you doing, man?
Oh, you hear my voice, Tom? I think it's about 60 degrees up here right now, brother.
Is it? That's awesome, man. That's crazy.
Dude, you kidding me? It's like spring. It's like I wish I could run. You'd want to actually exercise right now.
Totally. That's a beautiful thing, man. Well, that's great. You know, you're talking about February 23rd. You get a couple days of spring. You'd only need another foot of snow, and then you'd be all set for St. Patrick's Day.
Hey, listen, Tommy, I want to, before we get to my stock I called in, I want to just, make a little mention that I did call you about that ACIA, the one you just did a recap on.
Did you?
I called you about 2 weeks ago on that one. You told me it was going to 45, and, had a little bounce, but I'm fine with that, and I think you're going to end up being right in the end, you know what I mean?
Holy cow.
I don't know if you remember. I called it.
No,
like
I do
weeks.
Now. It's at 52 now. No, I do. I do, man. That's crazy. Wow. Okay.
Yeah. You know what happened was, Tom, after I sold it right when I called you, I called you about Under Armour.
Okay.
And you told me about, I asked you about this one, and I went on this thing I'm involved in. I don't want to mention the name, but a lot of the guys on the thing were actually mentioning the 45 number like you were. You know what I mean?
Yeah, wow. Okay.
So, anyways, I just wanted to, it was great. You get, like I said, you have to call. I called you 2 weeks, and it looks like it's going to go exactly where you said it was, as always, my brother.
No, not as always, but I appreciate it, man.
I know. I know. You know what I'm saying.
No, I do. Hey, listen, I love you, man. It's a beautiful thing. Totally.
You know what it is, Tom? You know what it is with you, Tommy? You say what it's going to do, and, sometimes it takes a while to get there, but in the end, a good majority of the time,
I know. I appreciate it, and in the market, folks, the key, I think, in the market is that whatever type of system you decide that works for you and you can do well with it, do it. That's what I've seen more than anything. I mean, I you know, I do the same thing over and over again. So it's, you know, sometimes they work great, you know, and in different.
Sorry, Tom. Sorry. Go ahead.
No, go ahead.
No, I'm just a little pumped up because I'm in 70-degree weather right now.
I don't blame you, man. You know what? That is really early, though, for up there, isn't it?
Oh, Tom, you know, buddy. You know everybody's. They all got T-shirts on up here, buddy. It's awesome. I'm picking up my daughter right now. Everybody's got T-shirts on.
Good. I want to see all those shots on.
Yeah. Today was the day. Today was the day. You could have worn them today. It was that nice today up here.
That's amazing, man. And you know, one of the guys in the den was just talking about the last 2 days in Denver, folks. Okay, it was 60 degrees and it's snowing today. So, pretty wild.
Yeah. Listen, Tom. Well, you know what I want to make is a little statement. And I mean, the goal was up so good today. Of course, I'm calling about Jay Nugg, and Jay Nugg really didn't move like, you know, you would have hoped it would have today. You know what
I
mean?
Know. Listen, this has been a tough trade, man. And what I mean by a tough trade, folks, is this. The equities have continued higher, and it always seems like they're challenging us, whether it's, you know, through the equity structure going higher or not going higher, and the gold contract. So let's go through this, because what I did is at the beginning of the show, I actually changed the rundown to get into this because I feel the same way. And it's like, we know going into a Friday, folks, if you're in the metals market, it's always a heavy trip, man. I mean, because they can take it apart. Now, I can tell you this, I'm staying with the larger picture as far as I can see, and that's gold now. The gold contract is in two separate ABC structures on the way up. You know, we took out another B point today. We took it out with 253,000 contracts versus 222. So that gives us 1281 is the projection from today. 1289 is the longer term projection. So when I look at that, I say, okay, man, that's where it's going. Okay, so now let's go, though, to the JNUG, okay? And the JNUG, folks, okay, is the direction, 300% bull position of the Junior Market Vectors Trust. Here, just stay right there, Mike. We're going to be right back, all right?
All right, pal. All right.
Our phone number is 877-927-6648. You stay right there, folks. We're coming right back. Dow finished up 34, NASDAQ down 25, S&P's up 1.5. We're going to be right back.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den, but wondered, what exactly is it? The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information, in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of your favorite TFNN shows, plus see all the charts as they happen, live, during those shows, and have access to all those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den, absolutely free, for 30 days. It will greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com. Tiger TV is an exciting way to experience TFNN programming. See high-definition video, giving you crystal-clear charts, as well as seeing some of the faces of TFNN's highly acclaimed financial experts with crisp, full-fidelity sound. Catch Tom O'Brien, John Logan, Steve Rhodes, Basil Chapman, Larry Pesavento, Think or Swim, David White, Andy Hecht, and Daryl Martin in crystal-clear, high-definition audio and video. Tiger TV, exclusively at TFNN.com.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls.
Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
Hi, I'm Steve Rhodes, host of The Trader's Edge, heard daily at TFNN.com and author of Mastering Probability, a daily investment and trading newsletter service that I send out each morning by 8 a.m. My morning newsletter service covers exactly what the markets have been doing since last night's close, providing you with an edge on your trading day ahead. You get actionable trading ideas, including the exact entry, stop, and profit targets. Plus, I'll teach you the patterns and hidden market correlations that will make you a better trader. As a subscriber, you'll gain access to my 90-minute money management workshop, where I'll teach you the secrets that'll save your assets. The bottom line, I've got your back, including a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the type of analysis I provide each trading day by signing up for Mastering Probability today. With nothing to lose, this is an offer you should not pass on. Mastering Probability can be found under trading newsletters on the front page of TFNN.com.
Tom, take your phone calls.
Now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648.
Internationally
at 727-445-1044.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. We're talking with Mike from Somerville. We're talking about the, we're going to talk specifically about JNUG. And JNUG, folks, is the bull position, the 300% direction bull position of the Junior Gold Miners Index. So if we take a look at this, let's just look at the GDX first. And if we take a look at this GDX, you know, bottom line is that, yeah, it went higher today and it couldn't hold price, you know. So it's like, okay, you know, now that means it's going to try to, you know, get into this $24.25 area probably tomorrow.
Yeah, I heard you earlier. I heard you say that earlier.
Yeah, and, you know, that's... that's dangerous on a Friday. We know that. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
You know, if we go to the GDXJ, and that's what the JNUG is trading off of. Now, this actually looks better, which is kind of cool, actually. Now, the this is what the difference is, folks. See, the difference is, you know, yesterday it rejected lower price, and we had done that yesterday with the GDX also, but it did 17 million shares going into 37.
You know what, Tommy? It does it almost every day.
Oh, no, it has. I know. Listen, man, I mean, it's refused to go down.
Yeah.
You know, now someone just brought something up in the den, and this is what we got to be cognizant of, folks, inside the gold and silver market. And what it is this. So gold is on a tear. And, you know,
yes,
as that's on a tear, like gold is a currency. So that could very well be on a tear. And then what you have to be cognizant of, if in fact we are going to get a pullback someday inside the main indices, the question is going to be when they're selling off the main indices, do they actually sell off the gold and silver equities too? Which we've also, we've also seen that before, okay?
Right.
You know, now the last time that that happened in a huge way, folks, is that people thought they were in the gold market and there's such a thing as a safe investment in 2007, and gold went from 1166, to 1133 to 666 in all of about 3 weeks. And the equities got killed also. So it's important to be cognizant that if, in fact, there's large downdrafts, everything goes.
Okay.
You know,
okay.
I'm just bringing it up so we all can be focused and be ready for anything. Do you know what I mean? It's like,
No, I appreciate it, Tommy. I appreciate it. Good point.
You know,
thank you.
So, you know, I think the identification thus far, however, right, this would be my take on it thus far. The identification thus far is that we are going to get, like if we bring the GDX up again, this GDX wants to trade up to this $28 area and $29 area. The JNUG and UG, and I'm talking about before a major pullback. And the JNUG wants to, you know, get up into this $14 area. And the reason I'm saying that is that You've had Barrick Gold do an ABC up, confirmed, and it's hanging up there. You've had Goldcorp do an ABC confirmed, it's hanging up there. You have Wrangell Resources also do an ABC up. That is almost at that level already. It's already 94, 93 is the number, you know. So you've had these equities come up, but it's been one of these tug of wars bringing them up, you know, and it's kept us all nervous enough, right? And that's pretty good, actually.
No, you know what, Tom? The thing is, you know, and I'm not, you know, the thing is, I trust you that much with gold that you're helping me to hang in there with it. You know what I mean? And you know, I'm not going to hold you to anything because I know the market. But you know, hey, the faith I have in you with the gold, and you know, you're a legend with the gold, kid. And if it goes down tomorrow, it goes down.
No, listen, I appreciate it. And I'll tell you, man. I mean, and all what happens, because what you're hearing here, folks, is that we've been doing it, you know, a long period of time, and we know you can take a hit beyond belief. So you got to be so careful because, you know, you hear these calls come in and out. And if you've been trading gold and gold equities for a long time, you know, people are coming in and out pretty heavily sometimes. So you got to be careful. That's what it comes down to.
You know what I just noticed, though, Tom? You're not really getting a lot of gold calls, though. Am I right or no?
No, you're right. No. Which is thank God. Believe me, yeah. I know. And it's still... What has happened is this, and this is what the deviant part of this is. You have the Fed continuing to say they're going to go up on rates. Another Fed governor just came out 20 minutes ago, okay, saying, yeah, hey, we should talk about March. Well, what you have here is that the bond market is saying, you know what, bonds are going up. Someone is putting huge amounts of money behind the trade. And if bonds are going up and rates are going down, well, they're not putting the rates up. And then what's also going on is that you have the dollar is pulling back. So, you know, it's kind of
Tommy,
a situation.
You've been right on with this bonds, buddy, in the last week. I'll tell you, you're right on with that, brother. You've been calling that.
Well, the bond one is going to be a wild one because, you know, when you look at the world rates, folks, this is what ends up happening. The world rates, I still can't figure out on a fundamental basis, how do we pay 2.3% for a 10-year? And France is paying 9/10, and Italy's paying the same as we are. Italy's broke. You know, so it's a supply and demand.
How many years you've been saying this? How many years you've been saying
this, Bob? I know. Listen, it's, you know, so. Hey.
I hear you.
One more thing. Hold it. Now, hey, one second. Well, let's go to the yen, because the yen, folks, okay, so the correlation in the yen. Now, this is really cool. The yen... Okay, so when the yen comes down, folks, okay, and gets stronger, gold gets a lot stronger. And the yen right now is only down 65 ticks today, but it looks to me like this yen's going to go after 111.63 tonight. And if 111.63 happens, we are going to see a big expansion in that physical gold market. And if we get, you know, 10, 20 bucks in the gold, these equities are going to go. So.
Tommy, you know, every day you could have played a gold on the Nadex and made every day this week. Every day.
Oh, I know. I know, man. I know.
I'm sure you did it.
Yeah, between that and the Euro, there was some good scores. There's no doubt.
Cooking. All right, pal.
Okay, have a great one.
Thank you.
Have a safe one. You got to love that accent, right, folks? I'll tell you. That is the accent. It's a beautiful thing. And, you know, there was some great points there. And that's why I wanted to continue that conversation. Because if you're in this market, all of us we've been doing mental gymnastics in our head, folks, okay, in order to stay in this trade, meaning that you keep going after it and after it and after it. And it's not even the context of, you know, that you think that it can only go one way. We know that it can go a lot of different ways. That the hardest thing, I think, in this one, well, the hardest and the easiest. The hardest was to stay in it. The easiest is to keep looking at the bond market saying, this is crazy, man. You know, because fundamentally, if in fact the Fed's going to, you know, continue raising the short-term interest rate, what you're going to have is that the longer-term rates, meaning the 2-10-year rates, are going to go up. And, you know, but they haven't. They've gone just the opposite way. You know, so There's no doubt about it. Yes, and he sounds exactly like a Southie born and raised. There's no doubt about that. We have a distinct accent. You stay right there, folks. We're going to be coming right back. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Dow finished up 34, NASDAQ down 25, S&Ps are flat. We're going to be right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date, active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters.
David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today.
Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund is currently offering 4-year first mortgages on many of the fully renovated properties that it has purchased. The first mortgages are third-party appraised with a maximum loan-to-value ratio of 70%, providing a secured investment that pays a fixed return of 5% annually, which works out to a monthly income of more than $416 per $100,000 investment with your principal intact and secured. These 4-year first mortgages are perfect for anyone looking for a secured investment that provides monthly income, much like a CD. For more information, email tigerfund@tfnn.com or click on the Tiger Real Estate Opportunity Fund banner along the right side of the tfnn.com homepage, or call our office directly at 877-518-9190. There's a limited supply, so act now.
Join Andy Hecht as he shows you how to make money in commodities. The Commodities Hour, next on TFNN.
Welcome back, folks. Let's go take a look at, it looks like the Gap come out with numbers too. So the Gap closed at $23.97. That is trading at $24.09. Let's see what they have to say. So their fourth quarter net sales was $4.43 billion. Their earnings were 51 cents. Bottom line is that they made a few dollars. Chart-wise here, this is actually one of the first retailers to go down. Yeah, so this topped out in September of 2014 at $46. You know, they're trying to claw their way back up into higher price. We'll see whether they can make it up into those levels. There's no doubt that's, you talk about a couple hits. These retailers, they've taken pretty amazing hits, actually. Restoration Hardware, they come out with numbers. That's trading up after the close right now. It's trading up $3. But that baby has already got killed. I mean, killed big time. OCLR. Let's see what that is. That is that's closed at 9:53. All right, we can do a quick call. We got Dave in Orlando. Hey, Dave, what's going on?
Yeah, I wanted to check with you on HL.
Okay, so Hecla, do you own it? You looking to buy it? What are we doing?
I own it. Looking to dump it, I think. I'm not sure.
Okay, yeah, well, you know, I mean, hey, it just went from $5 to $7. I mean, I wouldn't let this thing get under $5.98, and you're at $6.07. You know, this isn't a consolidation. It's had a great run, you know?
Right.
You know, there's nothing wrong with, let's see, so you're at 607, 530. I mean, it depends on, are you looking for this thing to break the highs? Tell me what you were looking at when you were getting in.
Well, I made money on it, and I,
okay, then
I just see the rest of the silver miners I have are going up or are holding their own, and it's going down.
Yeah, well, you know, it's interesting. So this was the strongest silver miner, folks, on the run from last January up to July. Then it consolidated. And, you know, it actually pulled back less than the rest of the, you know, miners too, Dave, you know. But it seems like it's struggling. You know, I agree with you, man. I mean, it's, you know, it seems like it's struggling. So, you know, there's nothing wrong with taking some bread, man, and waiting to see how it hits the 534 either. That's the other side of it. Because when you get a consolidation, it may be that it just ran too quick from that $145, $1.45 up to $7. Do you know what I mean?
Sure.
Because there's no doubt when you do look at a few of the others. Well, you know, Pan American Silver, that took a big hit too. You know, Great Panther is strong. You know, and silver's strong, you know, but when you go up that fast anyway, you know, it's consolidating out for a while. That's what it looks like it's doing. And there's plenty of others that you can go into too, so.
Okay.
Okay, man. Have a safe one. Yeah. And folks, as you come over to our website at TFNN, I'm going to be doing a workshop, a free workshop. Now, this is a workshop that's sponsored by Nadex. It's going to be in Tampa, Florida. You can check it out right on the front page of TFNN. It's going to be a great workshop. It's going to be on March 18th. And it's going to go from 7:30 in the morning to approximately noontime. And then we're going to have a continental breakfast in the morning. I'm going to do two sessions. Then we're going to have a tiger luncheon on the rooftop. We're going to pay for the luncheon. It'll be a cash bar, open bar. No, not cash bar. Cash bar, rather. So check it out on the front page of TFNN. Come on down, visit us. It's going to be a great time. The Phillies are down here. The Yankees are down here. Come on down, have a blast. Thanks for being here, folks. You stay right there. My name is Andy Hecht. It's going to be coming up next. Growling and prowling with you. Have a great one. Have a safe one. Meow! Go get them, folks.
Platinum, grains, crude oil, gold, copper, cattle, hogs, gasoline, natural gas, coffee, cotton, cocoa, and sugar. These are just some of the commodities mentioned in the most recent issue of Andy Hecht's Technomental Commodity Report. Andy publishes his weekly newsletter every Thursday morning, where he breaks down the commodity market and provides his subscribers with specific trading recommendations based on his trading methodology. By signing up for a free trial to the Technomental Commodity Report, you'll get a full 30 days to try out this powerful newsletter service and see for yourself the types of trades Andy has recommended for his subscribers. When you sign up for a 30-day free trial, you're under no obligation to pay anything. And should you decide to continue, you'll lock in the low rate of only $79 a month. Sign up right now for the Technomental Commodity Report and make sure you're ready to catch the next big trade in commodities. For more information and to get started today, visit the front page of TFNN.com.
This is TFNN.